I want to tell you a little story about Ernie. Ernie is a little dove I rescued out of my backyard. One dark evening, I went outside and I found a nest toppled over onto the ground. And next to it was a baby chick not one day old. He couldn't stand. He was laying on his side. He was shivering and really in bad shape. When I looked through the small shrubs, I saw another chick sitting there very still. I reached down gently, collected both chicks, and took them into the house. I got a shoebox and made a haphazard brooder for the chicks, with the help of an electric heating pad and a lamp. I had my wife watch the chicks while I drove to the pet store and bought some special food that I mixed with water so I could hand-feed them. Unfortunately, the injured chick did die, but Ernie lives on. To make a long story short, Ernie began to thrive. It is so much fun to see him shed his chick feathers and to see his adult feathers fill in. Once what was a homely little chick, Ernie has become a beautiful little bird. Periodically, he scares me to death. I will be intently working in the garden, and he suddenly flies up onto my shoulder or on top of my head. I actually think he does it on purpose. He makes almost no noise except for a little coo as he sits beside my ear. We do communicate. He tilts his head side to side, as if he actually understands what I'm saying. There is some truth as to why the dove are the symbol of peace. He is such a sweet bird. We had a really bad heat wave a few days ago. He sat there on the back of a lawn chair in the backyard. It was very hot, and I could tell he was just happy sitting there in the shade. Much too hot to be flying around, so I lifted up his water bowl, and he took a long drink. I am thinking about what lies ahead for him. You know, dove are monogamous. So will this little miracle find a mate and have offspring? And will it happen because I took the time and love to nurture him to adulthood? Truly a sweet, loving little bird. It was just a few moments later that a prairie falcon swooped down out of the sky and killed Ernie instantly. He quickly took Ernie away to the top of a knoll up behind our home, and he began to feed upon his flesh. Needless to say, I've been heartbroken about my little friend who loved me so much. He thought of me as his mother, and I knew he always felt safe when he sat quietly on my shoulder. I now realize there's a great biblical lesson for us to learn from Ernie. But of that day and hour knoweth no man, no, not the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Then two shall be in the field, the one shall be taken, and the other left. Two women shall be grinding at the mill, the one shall be taken, and the other left. And his disciples did ask where were they taken. And our Lord replied, Wheresoever the body is, there will the vultures be gathered together. You see, it does not matter how the world sees us. It does not matter how self-sacrificing we are. It does not matter how many good works we do. It does not matter how sweet and loving we appear to be. Unless we accept Christ as our personal Savior, we are destined to spend an eternity separated from God. If we fail to anticipate our Lord coming, if we fail to receive God's free gift of salvation, if we put off Jesus Christ for another day when it's more convenient, we will end up on that little knoll being consumed by a predator after being taken away.